Hello to the first semester students of BCom. This is Professor Deepa Tangankar and I'm dealing with financial accounting. In the previous class, I had given you this particular question and I've also explained to you as to which these transactions, where they are supposed to be posted. So as per that information, I have already prepared those accounts and have also posted those accounts because those transactions, because that becomes a little time consuming if I post the video or start posting those transactions at one shot, then it becomes difficult for me to make the video because it takes more than 1.5 hours just to paste those transactions. So I'll just explain you the problem and check the postings also so that it becomes easier for you to understand as well. Okay, let's begin with the question. So here, Mr. X furnished the following particulars and requested to prepare the final accounts of as on 31st 12 2019. Now this is the data which is in single entry system. You need to convert the single entry data into double entry system. So to prepare the double entry system, you have got 6 steps, as I've already explained you in the previous video. First one is you need to prepare the statement of affairs. Now here the statement of affairs has already been given in the question itself, so you need not prepare the statement of affairs. Next is you got to prepare the total debtors account, creditors account, bills receivable account, bills payable account, and we will also prepare the profit and loss account, trading and profit and loss account, and balance sheet. So let's go with the first aspect, that is in terms of assets and liabilities. Now what is being given here in assets and liabilities as on 1/1/2019. So this is nothing but the opening balances and this is nothing but the closing balances. Now here in assets and liabilities, the first thing that you have is cash in hand. Now cash in hand, if we are taking, we need not prepare the cash account. If we are preparing cash account, we need to post these entries over there. But we need not prepare the cash account because opening and closing balance has already been given. So no need of preparing cash account. Alright, so that particular step has been skipped off. Okay, next one. If cash account opening and closing balance was not been given, then we had to prepare cash account. But here, since the opening and closing balance has been given, we need not prepare the cash account. Next, bills receivable. Now bills receivable 25,000 and 35,000. So this balance will go to the bills receivable account. Let's go to bills receivable account. Opening balance is how much? 25,000. So opening balance is 25,000 over here and closing balance is 35,000. Alright, next. In balance sheet, we take the closing balance. Okay. So we also have to prepare the balance sheet. So closing balance of bills receivable comes here. That is bills receivable to the asset side. We write bills receivable, isn't it? So here closing balance of 35,000. Cash also, which is closing balance, is given. So cash opening balance goes to the account of cash. But here we need not prepare the cash account. So directly we'll take the closing balance of cash, which is 3,000. And bills receivable, which is 35,000. So 35, this bills receivable will have two entry. One is in the bills receivable account, another entry is in the balance sheet. Okay, next, after cash you have bills receivable. Next is debtors. Debtors 40,000, 50,000. Now again 40,000 and 50,000 goes to debtors account. Opening balance, two balance brought down, 40,000, that is opening balance. Closing balance, which is by, I'll just write it over here, I'll take it to the next line. All right, by, how much is the closing balance? By balance carried down, and how in the, what will you write for this closing balance? And then how much is the closing balance? 50,000. Opening balance is 40,000. Here opening balance is 40,000 and closing balance is 50,000. Now this closing balance of 50,000 will also go to the balance sheet. So let's go to the balance sheet. Here, look here, balance sheet. In balance sheet, where will you take debtors? Debtors comes to the asset side. Debtors is 50,000, but you also have RDD for it. It is given in the additional information. That is, you need to charge 10%, I guess, 2% of RDD. So that 2% of RDD comes over here. So that's the reason I have put these debtors into the inner column. All right. Next, after debtors, next goes is stock. Okay, now stock is 70,000 and 75,000. Now where will you take this opening stock and closing stock? Where will it go? It goes to the trading account. First entry to the trading account, that is opening stock here. Two opening stock 70,000 and closing stock 75,000. Okay, next, where will you take the another entry of stock? Another entry of closing stock goes to balance sheet. So here it is, stock of 75,000 in the balance sheet. Stock 75,000. I hope you have understood. One entry to trading and profit and loss account, to trading account here. Two opening stock 70,000, by closing stock 75,000, and another entry of closing stock goes to balance sheet here. That is stock 75,000, asset side. All right, next. After stock, what is the next thing that has been given? Plant and machinery, 40,000, 40,000. We will directly take this 40,000 of closing balance because this entry comes directly into the balance sheet. So this amount goes directly to the balance sheet. So let's go to the balance sheet here. Stock, plant and machinery is to the debit side of, I mean, the asset side of balance sheet. So plant and machinery, write it in the inner column because you have depreciation. This depreciation we need to calculate. I have just written it before itself, but I'll just calculate this later on. Right? Depreciation has been given on plant and machinery. So that's the reason you will be writing this particular amount in the inner column. Next, after depreciation, I mean, after plant and machinery, what do you have? You'll take the closing balance of plant and machinery. All right. Land and building. Land and building is 60,000. This is nothing but again the closing balance which is to be taken to the balance sheet. So let's go to the balance sheet. In balance sheet, you have land and building. Now there is no depreciation or any such information in case of land and building. So directly the amount will be taken to the outer column. Next, after this, after land and building, you have next is trade creditors. Now trade creditors, opening balance is given and closing balance is given. We have also, now see, this goes to the trade creditors, opening and closing balance goes to the creditors account as well as to the balance sheet. Closing account, closing balance goes to the balance sheet and opening and the another, that is closing amount, goes to the trade creditors account. So let's go to the creditors account here. Opening balance, buy balance brought down. This is nothing but opening balance. I'll write here. Opening balance. Okay. How much is the amount? 36,000. Okay. And next, the closing balance is over here. We will write the closing balance by 2. 2. I'll just... opening balance is written over here, so closing balance 2, balance carried down in the bracket, closing balance. Okay, and how much is the closing balance? It is 40,000. Closing balance is 40,000. So 40,000. Okay, next. Now this closing balance we have taken of opening balance comes to the debit side, credit side, and closing balance to the debit side of trading, I mean the creditors account. Next entry of this goes to the balance sheet. So over here, creditors, okay, trade creditors, which is 40,000. Closing balance will be taken to the balance sheet. Okay, next. After creditors, you have bills payable. Bills payable 20,000 and 25,000. Bills payable opening balance is 20,000, closing balance is 25,000. So where will this entry come? Let's go to the bills payable account. Here, opening balance of bills payable is over here. buy balance brought down 20,000 in the bracket opening balance. Next, closing balance, two balance carried down 25,000 in the bracket closing balance. I have put these entries before itself so that it will be time consuming. Okay, so the opening balance is 20,000, closing balance is 25,000. Closing balance of bills payable will also go to the balance sheet. So here bills payable comes to the liability side. Okay, so bills payable, and then you have 25,000. Okay, let me just check if I have written 25,000 in bills payable account. Yes, the closing balance is 25,000. The same amount will be taken to the balance sheet as 25,000. Clear? Next, after bills payable, what is else been given in the question? After bills payable, you have capital. Okay, capital, which is 1,80,000. Now, where will you take capital? Capital directly goes to the balance sheet. Okay, so let's take capital. Write down capital in the bracket opening, because if at all there is closing capital also, we will be taking it. But there is no such closing capital being given. So we will just write the amount in the inner column, because we need to add net profit and drawings, which has already been given. You need not write this all. Just go step by step, because that becomes easier for you to understand. I am solving this before itself, because that becomes because that is time consuming for me. All right. So capital you write down in the inner column, 1,80,000. Next, after capital, what is the next thing that has been given? After capital, you have cash transactions during the year. So cash transaction, in that you have receipts being given. Now, receipts from debtors, 2 lakhs. Okay, now this is nothing but this entry will be what? To the debtors account and cash account. So receipts from debtors. So cash account debit to debtors account. That will be the entry. So let's go to the debtors account. Cash account debit to debtors account. So debtors account will be credited by cash, which is 2 lakhs of rupees. I hope you have understood. This entry of 2 lakhs of rupees. This one, receipts from debtors. What will be the entry here? Debtors account debit to cash. All right, so here debtors account has been debited, it has been credited, because debtors account debit to cash. So debtors account will be by cash, and then received from debtors, which is 2 lakhs of rupees. Okay, next, the next thing is, after receipts from debtors, next is receipts from bills receivable. Okay, bills receivable. What will be the entry here? Receipts from bills receivable. You're receiving. So cash account debit to bills receivable. Okay, so bills receivable account will be credited by cash. Let's go to, yeah, bills receivable account credited by cash. So that the amount is 1 lakh of rupees. I hope you have understood. This is bills receivable received. So cash account has to be debited. So cash account debit to bills receivable. So bills receivable account is credited by cash 1 lakh of rupees. All right, next. After this, what is the next transaction? After bills receivable and bills payable, receipts from, okay, this debtors and bills receivable. Next is payment. Okay, now payment. In this you have wages, salary, bills payable and trade creditors and so on. Let's go for the single entry first. Salary, where will you take salary? Salary goes to the profit and loss account. So let's go to profit and loss account. To salary, 10,000 rupees. Clear? Next, after salary, what has been given? After salary, you have wages. Where will you take wages? Salary goes to profit and loss account. Wages goes to trading account. And how much is the amount? 15,000. So let's go to the trading account. Here, trading account. You will first leave little space, because if at all there are opening stock and closing stock and all, that comes over here. Okay, we have already posted this opening and closing stock. Okay, wages. So wages is 15,000. Next, after wages, what is the next thing that has been given? Bills payable. Bills payable is 1,20,000. So where will this entry come? This is bills payable against bills. Okay, so it will not come in case of balance sheet because it is against bill. So what will be the entry? It will come in cash account and bills payable account. So it will go to the bills payable account because it is against bills. Okay, so bills payable, since it is bills paid, what will be the entry? Bills payable account debit to cash. Okay, so to cash 1,20,000. Okay, because it is against bills, it comes in case of bills payable account. Okay, it will not come in case of balance sheet. This amount of 1,20,000 does not come in case of balance sheet because it is against bills. All right, so to cash in the bracket paid against bills 1,20,000. All right, next. After wages and bills payable, next goes is trade creditors. Now trade creditors is 1,40,000. This is also against bills. So where will it come? It will not come in case of balance sheet, but it will directly come in case of total creditors account. So let's go to total creditors account here. Total creditors account to cash paid against bills, 1,40,000. I hope you have understood this. Okay, since we are making payment to creditors, so creditors account debit to cash. So creditors account is debited to cash 1,40,000. Okay, what you will write narration for this? Paid against bills or paid against creditors. Next, after wages, bills payable, then trade creditors, then general expenses. General expenses, how much? 8,000. Where will general expenses of 8,000 go? It will come to profit and loss account. So here, two general expenses, 8,000. Okay, in profit and loss account. This information is in terms of trading account. This information is of profit and loss account. Okay, leave a little space of after trading account and then take the profit and loss account. So salary and general expenses. Next, after general expenses, you have drawings. Drawings is 5,000. So where will you take drawings? Drawings directly goes to the balance sheet under the head capital. Okay, so I'll just write this amount of, you write capital of 1,80,000. Then you leave a little space and then write less drawings, 5,000 rupees. You will understand why I have written this now, but in some time, but till then you just leave 2-3 lines and then write drawings of 5,000. Okay, drawings is to be deducted because that is an expense. So less drawings, 5,000 rupees. All right, next. After drawings, what do you have? Other information. Now, anything that has been given in case of other information will have two effect. Okay, one is to the debtors account or bills payable account, or in terms of balance sheet, another entry will, profit and loss account or trading account, and another entry will be in the balance sheet. So any one of the account, and then it goes to the balance sheet. All right. So here, discount allowed 2,000 rupees will have two entries. So where will be the first entry? You are allowing discount. Discount allowed is to the debtors. So buy discount allowed 2,000 rupees in the debtors account. So this is to the debtors account. By discount allow, you give discount to your debtors. You are allowing discount to your debtors. Okay, when you're making sales, you will give discount. So by discount allowed is an expense. So it goes to the credit side of debtors account. Debtors account debit to, cash account debt, this will go to the debtors account to the credit side, 2,000 rupees. Next, where will be this another entry? It goes to the profit and loss account to discount allowed 2,000 rupees. Have you understood? It's an expense. So discount allowed profit and loss account is debited by 2,000 and debtors account is credited by 2,000. Since it is an expense, it comes to the debit side of profit and loss account to discount allowed. Clear? Next, after discount allowed, you have discount received. Now, where will you receive from? You are making discount allowed goes to the debtors. You are receiving benefit, receiving discount from creditors. Okay, so two discount received. Okay, and one entry is to the total creditors account. another entry goes to the profit and loss account credit side because it is an income. So by discount received 1000 rupees. Clear? Here it is. By discount received 1000 rupees. One entry to the total creditors account, another entry to the CR. Creditors account by discount received, and then one entry to the creditors account, another entry to the profit and loss account. Next. After discount received, what is the next thing that has been given? Yes, discount received. Provision for doubtful debts is 2%. Provision for doubtful debts means RDD. RDD is one effect will be to the balance sheet, another effect will be to the profit and loss account. So let's go to profit and loss account first. Here, profit and loss account RDD at 2%. 2% on what? On 50,000. This is nothing but the amount of debtors. Okay, so on 50,000, if you take 2%, the amount goes to 1000. So one effect to the profit and loss account debit side, another effect to the asset side of balance sheet. So asset side of balance sheet, debtors 50,000 less RDD at 2%, which is 1000. Okay, so the amount will be 50,000 minus 1000, which is 49,000. Okay, next. After that RDD, what is it? Depreciation on plant and machinery at 10%. We have finished with RDD. Next is depreciation on plant and machinery at 10%. What will be the effect here? It will have two effects. One effect will be in profit and loss account. Another effect will be in the balance sheet. So let's go first to the profit and loss account. You are giving 10% depreciation on 40,000. That is the amount of plant and machinery. So depreciation on plant and machinery. Two, depreciation on plant and machinery. Since it is an expense, it comes to the debit side of profit and loss account. So two, depreciation on plant and machinery, 40,000 at 10%, which is 4,000. This is the first effect in profit and loss account. Second effect comes to the balance sheet. Where will it come? Depreciation on plant and machinery. Plant and machinery amount is written as 40,000. Less depreciation at 10%, which is 4,000. Outer column, 40,000 minus 4,000, which is 36,000. This is the amount of plant and machinery. Okay, next. After this, you have, there's no other information being given. We have taken discount allowed, discount received, provision for doubtful debts, then depreciation on plant and machinery. So there's no other information. So let's tally the accounts. All right. Let's go first with the debtors account. So when you want to first close up with the debtors account, before that you will have to close the bills receivable account. Okay. Now in bills receivable account, what is the information? You have 1,35,000. Here you have 25,000. So the credit side is more. 1,35,000 is the balance. So 1,35,000. Copy the same amount over here to the debit side. Okay. Now 1,35,000 minus 25,000. How much is the balance? Balance goes to 1,10,000. Okay, and what you will write in front of this? 2. Okay, 2 debtors. 2 debtors account. Okay, and what will be the narration for this? Balancing figure. All right. Now, where will you take this? This is nothing but 2 debtors account, 1,10,000. So this will go to the debtors account, to the credit side of debtors. By what will you write for this? By bills receivables. by bills receivables. By bills receivables, what will you write for this bills receivable account? Okay, I'll just write down the shortcut bills receivable account. Okay, BR account, just for your information. Okay, how much is the amount? 1,10,000. 1,10,000. Okay, next. After this, after we finish off with the debtors account, what do? We close the debtors account. So how much is the amount here? 2 lakh plus 2,000 plus 1,10,000 plus 50,000. So what will be the balance? 3,62,000. 3,62,000. Copy the same balance over the assets, debit side, that is 3,62,000. Next, 3,62,000 minus 40,000. How much is the balance? Balance goes to 3,22,000. And what will you write in front of this? To credit sales. In the bracket, balancing figure. Okay, to credit sales, 3,22,000 balancing figure. Now, where will you take this credit sales of 3,22,000? It goes to the trading accounts. Credit sales, where will you take? Trading account, right? So where will it come? Debit side or credit side? Credit side. So to balance, that is to credit sales. From where did you get this? From total, from creditor's account. Okay, from creditor's account, which is 3,22,000. Okay, next. We are done with the debtors account. We have finished closing with the debtors account. We have finished closing with the bills receivable account. Next is the total creditors account. So before we close up with the total creditors account, we need to first close the bills payable account. So let's go to bills payable account here. Now in bills payable account, just a minute. In bills payable amount, in bills payable account, how much is the balance here? 1,20,000 plus 1,25,000, which turns to 1,45,000. Okay, write down the same balance to the credit side. Okay, that is 1,45,000. 1,45,000 minus 20,000. How much it turns to? 1,25,000. So write down 1,25,000. And what will you write in front of this? By creditor's account. By creditor's account. In the bracket, balancing figure. Okay, now this, where will you take? By creditors account. So it goes to the total creditors account. Okay, so let's go to total creditors account and post this particular entry. So creditors account to here to bills payable. To bills payable account, how much is the entry? What's the amount here? 1,25,000. So 1,25,000. Okay, What will you write from? Where did you get this amount? Creditors account, total creditors account. Okay, even if you don't write, that's fine. All right, now let's close. We have posted the amount of 1,25,000, that is balancing figure of bills payable. How much is the balance of bills payable? That is, after you tally bills payable account, balance is 1,25,000. This balance will go to total creditors account. So we have taken into total creditors account 1,25,000 to bills payable account. All right. Next. Now let's close the total creditors account. So here 1,40,000 plus 1,000 plus 1,25,000 plus 45,000 will go back, will get 3,06,000 rupees. All right. 3,06,000 rupees. So take down the same to the credit side. 3,06,000 rupees. So here 3,06,000 minus 36,000. How much it turns to? 2,70,000. Okay, 2,70,000. And what will you write in front of this? By credit purchase. Okay, in the bracket, balancing figure. Close the bracket. Okay, now this credit purchase, where will you take it? To the trading account. So let's go to the trading account, and here we have taken credit sales over here. So credit purchase comes over here. So credit purchase, and how much is the amount? Credit purchase is 2,70,000. Okay, next, after this we have closed with the, let's go with the in the beginning. See, debtors account, which is closed, and we have taken the balance to trading account. Creditors account has also been closed, and the amount is taken, that is this amount of purchase, credit purchase, has already been taken to trading account. This balance goes to debtors account, this balance goes to creditors account. So which is the next account to be closed? That is the profit and loss account. So let's close the profit and loss account. Closing of profit and loss account and balance sheet, we'll see it in the next class. Thank you.